Today we will begin chapter 14, statistics. In statistics we have one important term, that is data. Data is collection of information. Suppose we are going to collect the marks of 50 students in a class. That is one data. Marks of 50 students. Suppose the marks out of 100 are, then 70, 45, 90, 72, 14, etc. So that is one data. Collection of informations. Or we can collect age of 10 students in a group, or we can collect the weight of students in a class, etc. So these are collection of informations, that is data. Then statistics is a science or a discipline which deals with the collection of data, analysis of data, interpretation of data, representation of data, etc. Statistics is a science or a discipline deals with the collection of data, analysis of data, interpretation of data, representation of data, etc. So here, collection of data, how to collect data, how to analyze data, how to interpret data, and how to represent different types of representation we studied in lower class. The data can be represented in bar graph, in pie chart, in histogram, etc. So this all comes in statistics. And we cannot say statistics is a branch of mathematics. Statistics is a separate subject, separate discipline, which deals with the collection of data, analysis of data, etc. And here this subject is related to mathematics, so that's why we are studying statistics with the mathematics. But actually this is not a branch of mathematics. And here in this chapter we are going to learn average of a data. We are going to learn average of a data, how to calculate average of a data. Suppose we have marks of 50 students, then we can calculate the average of that marks, average marks of that 50 students. We can calculate the average in different methods. First one is mean, arithmetic mean, then median, then mean, median and mod. So we are going to learn here in this chapter mean, median and mod. And we can take one example. Suppose we need to compare the performance of two students in mathematics. So here we have two students A and B. We need to compare their performance in mathematics. So we can easily compare if we give them a test. And suppose A got 92 out of 100 and B got 40 out of 100. A got 92 and B got 40 marks. Then we can easily say A performed well because A got 92 marks. But in the case of, suppose we want to compare the performance of two classes, performance of 10th A and 10th B. We need to compare the performance of students in 10th A and 10th B, performance in mathematics. So we can conduct exam, and from 10th A we will get a, suppose we have 50 students in both the sections, and when we collect their marks, from 10th A we will get 50 marks, and from 10th B we will get another set of 50 marks. Suppose 10th A, we have marks 70, 90, 78, 40, 3, 14, etc. And similarly, we have from 10th B, 100, 17, 98, 32, 45, etc. 50 marks. Then we need to compare the performance of students in 10th A and the performance of students in 10th B. When we compare the performance of two students, it's very easy, we can compare the 2 marks. But when we compare the performance of two groups, it is very difficult to compare, because here we have 50 marks and here also we have 50 numbers. So if we compare this 3 and this 100, then we cannot justify that comparison. By comparing this 3 and by 100, if you are saying this batch is performing well, then we cannot justify that comparison. Or if you compare this 40 and this 32, and we are saying this batch is better than this one, so we will not accept that comparison. So here we need to find a number representing 10th A and another number representing 10th B. So then we will compare that two numbers. So here 50 numbers, comparing 50 numbers, here we have 50 numbers and here we have another 50 numbers, and comparing that two sets of numbers may be different. So we can find a number representing 10th A and another number representing 10th B. So when we take a number representing 10th A, so we cannot take this 3. So we need to take a central value from here. We need to take a central value or middle number, middle value or central value from this number, and similarly a center value from here. Suppose here 10th A, roll number 1 to 50, and their marks out of 100, and 10B, roll number 1 to 50, and marks out of 100, roll number 1 got of 32, 50, etc. Suppose their marks, and here their marks, roll number 1, roll number 2, etc. their marks. Then we need to take a middle one, a central value from here, and another central value from here. Then we will compare that to central values. So that central values, that is average. So these all numbers, from when we take average from 10th A, so these all numbers, these all marks near to that central value. And similarly, when we take a central value from 10th B, and here these all numbers near to that central value, that central number, that is called average. Then we can compare that average, then we can decide which section is better. And here average we can calculate in three different ways. So first one is mean, arithmetic mean or mean. So when we calculate mean, in our class you studied sum of all the observations divided by number of observations. So here we have 50 numbers, so each number is called, each of them is called observation. In a data, each entry is called observation. So 70 is an observation, 90 is an observation, 78 is an observation, etc. So when we calculate the mean, mean is sum of all observations divided by number of observations, that is one average, that is mean. Then similarly, we have three average here, mean, then median, then mode. Mean, median and mode. So mean, that is sum of all observations divided by number of observations in raw data. And median, so here we will arrange these all numbers in ascending order or descending order for calculating median. And we will take a number from the middle one, so that is median. Then third one is mode. So mode is the most repeated observation. So from this data, we will find which number repeated more, most repeated observation. So that is mode. So mean, median and mode. So these are the average. So they are all central values from the data. So we can say that these are the measures of central tendency. Measures of central tendency, because these all values are from the middle of the data, center of the data, central value of the observations, and these all numbers are near to that value, because that value is the middle one. So these all numbers tends to that particular value. That's why they are called the measures of central tendency. Mean, median, and mode are called the measures of central tendency, and they are called average of the data. So now we are going to study mean. And here, when we learn mean, arithmetic mean in 9th standard you studied. So when we get a data, that data can be ungrouped data. So the datas are mainly two types, grouped data and ungrouped data. Suppose we have 50 marks, 10, then 75, 90, 25, 4, 30, 98, etc. It is going on. We have 50 marks. Then this is ungrouped data. Ungrouped data. They are not in any group. And if you want, we can make them into group. So 0 to 10. 0 to 10 can be a first group. 0 to 10. 10 to 20. 20 to 30. 30 to 40, 40 to 50, total. Suppose it is out of 100, then 40 to 50, 50 to 60, etc. 90 to 100. Then 0 to 10, here it is marks, and here number of students. Suppose 3 students got marks in between 0 and 10, then we will write the 3, and here 2, here suppose 10 students, and here 4 students, etc. And here 3, etc. Then their total will be total number of students, that is 50. So this is grouped data. And here it is ungrouped data. So here we have 50 numbers, but they are not in a group. And here that numbers are in a group. And here number of students, that is given here, in between 0 and 10, 3 students. In between 10 and 22 students, etc. So this is grouped distribution table. Grouped data, grouped distribution table. And this is ungrouped data. So first we will learn how to find the mean of ungrouped data. We already learned how in 9th standard. So mean, ungrouped data. So one formula is mean x bar. Mean, this is a symbol, mean x bar in 9th standard you studied. Mean is equal to sum of all observations divided by number of observations. So that symbol is sigma xi divided by n. So sum of all the observations divided by number of observations. Suppose we have 50 marks, then sigma xi, that means the sum of that 50 marks, divided by number of observations, that is 50. So that is mean, x bar. And we have one more formula in ungrouped data. Sometimes we may have frequency distribution table. Marks, then number of students. Then 10 marks, 3 students. 17, 5 students. 45, 8 students, 90, 5 students, 98, 3 students. Suppose we have a frequency distribution table. So this is ungrouped data. We don't have group here. This is ungrouped data, but we have frequencies here. So in that case, in 9th standard we studied, we can calculate the mean. So marks can be taken as xi, and number of students can be taken as fi. Then we will find xi into fi. Sum of the we will find the product of marks and number of students. So 10 into 3, 30. Then 5 into 17, 8 into 45, 5 into 90, 3 into 19, etc. Then we will find the sum of these all. That is sigma, sum of these all, sigma xi fi. Sum of the products, that is sigma fi xi. Then sum of the frequencies, that is sigma fi. Sum of the frequencies, that is sigma fi. and the sum of the products of xi and the fi, that is sigma fi xi. Then the mean will be mean x bar is equal to sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. So that is second formula. If the given data is in frequency distribution level, if it is in frequency distribution form, then we can find the mean by using this formula, that is sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. So here in first column we have observed marks, that is xi, then number of students, that is fi, then their product we will write, then sum of the products, that is sigma fi xi, that is in the numerator, then sum of the frequencies, that is total number of students, that is it can be written as capital N also, sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi, or we can write up sigma fi xi divided by capital N, that is sum of the frequencies. So that is the formula for finding mean in ungrouped data. So this formula we studied in class 9. So in 10th standard we are going to learn grouped data, mean of grouped data. Mean of grouped data. Grouped data. And here one example. Suppose we conducted one exam and the total marks are 50 and groups, marks we can write, then number of students. And here marks 0 to 10, then 10 to 20, then 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and 40 to 50. So this exam is out of 50. And here 0 to 10, suppose we have 5 students, and here 10 students, and here 10 students, then here 20 students, and here 5 students. So total 50 students. We conducted one exam in a class, total 50 students, and the marks are in grouped data, 0 to 10 5, 10 to 20 10, 20 to 30 10, 30 to 40 20, and 40 to 50 5 students, and there's total 50 students. So this is one data, this is grouped data. And here we have class intervals. 0 to 10 is a class interval. 0 to 10 is a class interval. 10 to 20 is another class interval. And similarly 30 to 40, 40 to 50 etc. are class intervals. And here when we take a class interval, this is called lower limit of the class interval. Lower limit of the class interval. And this is called upper limit of the class interval. Upper limit and lower limit. Upper limit of a class interval, lower limit of a class interval. Then class size is upper limit minus lower limit. Upper limit minus lower limit, that is called class size. Size of the class is upper limit minus lower limit. And here the class size will be 10 minus 0, that is 10, or 30 minus 20, that is 10, 50 minus 40, that is 10. So here class size is same. So that is called class size is upper limit minus lower limit, that is size of the class. Size of the class interval or size of the class. That is class size. Then we have one more term, that is class mark. Class mark. Class size, then class mark. Class mark is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. That is called class mark. Lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So if you want to find the class mark of this class interval. So here class mark, lower limit. Lower limit is equal to 40 plus upper limit, that is 50. Divided by 2. So 90 upon 2, that is 45. So that is class mark. So here 45 is the class mark. So class mark is the middle value 40 to 45. So the central value, that is 45, that is class mark. So class mark is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So here class mark and class size. Class size is upper limit minus lower limit divided by 2. Then when we find the mean of a grouped data, so this will be given in exam. Table will be given, marks or class intervals will be given, number of students or frequency will be given. Then we will make one more column, and that column is class mark. Class mark, class mark, class mark or XI. Class mark or XI. So class mark is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So here 0 plus 10 divided by 2, that is 10 upon 2, that is 5. And here lower limit 10, upper limit 20, 10 plus 20, that is 30, 30 upon 2, that is 15. And here 20 plus 30, 50, 50 upon 2, that is 25. Then after getting 1 or 2, 2 or 3, then we can easily find the next one. Here 25 and here it will be 35 and here it will be 45. Or we can do like this, first one 5, then we can add a class size. So class size is upper limit minus lower limit, 10 minus 0, that is 10, 5 plus 10, 15, 15 plus 10, 25, 25 plus 10, 35, 35 plus 10, 45. So we got class mark. Then number of students, that is FI, number of students, that is FI. And the class mark is XI, and we can use the formula. In ungrouped data, we used one formula. In frequency distribution form, the same formula. We will make another table. So that is XI into FI, or FI into XI. FI into XI. That is sum of their product. 5 into 5, 25. 15 into 10, 150. 25 into 10, 250, then 35 into 20, 700, then 45 into 50, 225. So sigma FI XI. Now we will find the sum of these all. So sum of these all, that is sigma FI XI. Then sum of the frequencies, that is sigma FI, sigma FI. Sum of the products of FI and XI, that is sigma FI XI, and sum of the frequencies, that is sigma FI. Then mean X bar is equal to sigma FI XI divided by sigma FI. So that is one method. So this method is called direct method. Direct method. So if grouped data is given. If grouped data is given, then when we find the mean by using direct method, first we have to find the class mark. So class mark is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So class mark we will find. Then frequency already given. Then we will find the product of class mark and frequency. That is FI XI. So we have to make two more additional columns. So FI XI we will find, then we will find their sum, that is sigma FI XI, then sum of the frequency, that is sigma FI, then this sigma FI XI divided by sigma FI, that is mean. This is direct method. So that this is the formula for finding the mean in direct method. Then we have one more method, that is assumed mean method. So this is direct method. Then we need to find assumed mean method. In assumed mean method, the formula is X bar is equal to A plus sigma FI DI divided by sigma FI. So that is assumed mean method formula. And here where DI equal to XI minus A, and A, that is called assumed mean. Assumed mean. So this is the formula. X bar is equal to, in assumed mean method, the mean is equal to A plus sigma FI DI divided by sigma FI. and here A is assumed mean and Di is Xi minus A. Xi minus A. So we will learn how to find, how to calculate mean by assumed mean method. So when we, this is direct method. So here in the question we will have class marks, class intervals will be given, frequencies will be given. And for direct method we will add two more columns, that is class mark Xi and Fi Xi. But in assumed mean method, this column is not required. But we need a class mark. So these two columns will be given in question. And we will make one additional column, that is class mark. Then after that, we will make one column, that is Di equal to Xi minus A. Di equal to Xi minus A. Then the formula is A plus sigma Fi Di. Then the next column is Fi into Di. So we have to make three columns here. In direct method we will make only two columns, class mark then Fi Xi. In assumed mean method we have to make three columns, class mark will be there, then Di is equal to Xi minus A, then Fi Di. So here A is called assumed mean. So here we have taken class mark. Then we want to take one assumed mean. We are assuming one number from here as a mean. So usually we take from the middle. So here we can take 25 as assumed mean. So we can take 35 also. But usually we take from the middle. When we take from the middle, then it will be easy to calculate. So here 25 is the middle number. And suppose we have one more number, 55 also. And if we have 55 here, then we have two numbers in the middle, 25 and 35. So you can take any one of this. Any one of this. If you take 25, we will get answer. And if you take 35 also, we will get an answer. We can take any number from the middle. So here I am taking 25. 25 is the assumed mean. That is A. A is equal to 25. A is equal to 25. And the next step is Di equal to Xi minus A. So here Xi minus A. That is Xi, 5 minus A, 5 minus 25, 5 minus 25 is equal to minus 20. Then Di is equal to Xi minus A, so here A is equal to 25, so 5 minus 25, that is minus 20. Then 15 minus 25, or 15 minus 25, that is minus 10. Then 25 minus 25, that is 0. Then 35 minus 25, that is 10. Then 45 minus 25, that is 45 minus 25, that is 20. So once again, here class mark. Then from the middle, we will take a assumed mean. So here we can take 25 as assumed mean. And that is A, small letter A, that is assumed mean. Then we have two more columns, Di equal to Xi minus A, then Fi into Di. And here Di, that is Xi minus A. That is Xi, this is x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. So x1 minus A, that is Xi minus A, that is 5 minus 25. 5 minus 25, minus 20. Then 15 minus 25, that is minus 10. Then 25 minus 25, that is 0. Then 35 minus 25, that is 10. Then 45 minus 25, that is 20. Then next column, we need to find the product of these two. So 5 into 20, minus 100. 5 into 20 is equal to minus 100. Then 15 into minus 10. 5 into minus 20, that is minus 100. 15 into minus 10, that is minus 150. 0 into 25, that is 0. Then 35 into 10, that is 350. Then 25 into 45, that is 900. So here in assumed mean method, the calculation will be easy. Compared to direct method, here the calculation will be easy. So now we have to find the sum of these products. Sum of Fi Di, that is sigma Fi Di. So here these two numbers are positive numbers, and here we have to sum of the negative numbers, then their difference. So we will get a sigma fi di. Then sigma fi, that is sum of the frequencies. So that is same 50. And A, assumed mean. So here when we find the, when we calculate mean, so here assumed mean, that is 25. And here plus or minus, that depends on the sum. Sometimes here we will get a here 1250 minus, then 150 plus 100, 250. So their sum is plus 1000. So we will get a positive 1000. So 1000 divided by sigma fi, so 50. Then 1000 divided by 50. Then when we simplify, we will get a mean. So this is assumed mean method. So here marks will be given, class intervals will be given, frequency will be given. Then we have to make three more columns in assumed mean method. First one is class mark. Class mark we will get a middle value. Then from the class mark we will find one number from the middle, that is assumed mean. Then we will find xi minus a. 5 minus 25, minus 20, 15 minus 25, minus 10, 25 minus 25, 0, 35 minus 25, 10, 45 minus 25, 20. Then the last column, that is fi into di, that is frequency into, sorry, here I made one mistake. Yeah? So here we need to find fi into di. So here fi into di, that is 5 into minus 20. 5 into minus 20, that is minus 100. Then 10 into minus 10, that is minus 100. Then 10 into 0, that is 0. Then 20 into 10, that is 200. Then 5 into 20, that is 100. So here I made one mistake. Yeah? So here I multiplied it. Earlier I find the product of di and xi. That is wrong. We need to find the product of fi and di. Product of fi and di. So here fi, that is 5. 5 into di. That is 5 into minus 20. That is minus 100. Then 10 into minus 10. That is minus 100. Then 10 into 0. That is 0. Then 20 into 10, that is 200. Then 5 into 20, that is 100. Then we will find their sum. And here minus 200. And here 300. And their sum is 100. Minus 200 plus 300, that is 100. And here we will replace sigma fi di, that is 100, divided by sigma fi, that is 50. That is 25 plus 2, that is 27. So 27 is the mean. And here when we calculate mean by assumed mean method, the calculation will be easy. So this is assumed mean method. So we need to write the formula. So we can find the mean of a grouped data in two different methods. First one is direct method. In direct method, the formula is direct method. In direct method, the formula mean x bar is equal to sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. So that is mean direct method. Then assumed mean method. Assumed mean method. In assumed mean method, the formula for finding mean, that is x bar is equal to a plus sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi, a plus sigma fi di divided by sigma fi, where a, that is assumed mean, and di is equal to xi minus a. So this is the formula for finding assumed mean. Formula for finding mean by assumed mean method. That is x bar is equal to a plus sigma fi di divided by sigma fi. So where a is assumed mean and di equal to xi minus a. And here in NCERT book we have one more method, that is step deviation method. Step deviation method, but that method deleted from the syllabus. So we need to do only two methods, that is direct method and assumed mean method. So I already explained one question here, direct method and assumed mean method. And when we have two digit numbers or single digit numbers, then direct method is easy. And sometimes we may have three digit numbers or four digit numbers, etc. In that case, we will do by assumed mean method. So the calculation will be easy. Otherwise, we have to find the product of three digit numbers. So it will take time. So we can do that type of questions by assumed mean method. If we have three digit numbers or bigger number, when we get a bigger number, we will calculate a mean by assumed mean method. Or sometimes it will be mentioned in the question, find the mean of the following data by using assumed mean method. So then we will do by assumed mean method. So I already explained, so we can do these all questions by this method. So it's not a difficult. And here one question is there, question number 3 I will explain. So in exercise 14.1, we can do these all questions by any one of this method, direct method or assumed mean method. Step deviation method is deleted from the syllabus. So you will not face any difficulty. So I already explained one question, so the same way we will do. And here third question is something different, so that question I will explain. Question number 3, exercise 14.1. The following distribution shows the daily pocket allowance of children of a locality. The mean pocket allowance is rupees 18. Find the missing frequency. So here one frequency is missing, and here mean given, we need to find the missing frequency. So first we can make the table, class intervals, then frequency 11 to 13, frequency 7, 11 to 13, 13 to 15, 15 to 17, 17 to 19, then 19 to 21, then 21 to 23, then 23 to 25. Then the frequencies 7, 6, 9, 13, F, 5 and 4. So these are the frequency. And here it's given, mean is equal to 18. So we need to find the value of F. One frequency is missing. So if one frequency is missing, we can do by direct method or assumed mean method. So usually direct method is easy when we calculate missing frequencies. If the numbers are small number, here the numbers are not a bigger one, small numbers only, two digit numbers. So we can find the mean by direct method. Then from there we will get the value of F. So when we, this is a grouped data, so when we find a mean by direct method, so we have to make it two more columns. First one is xi, that is class mark. Then fi into xi. So the first column is xi, then fi into xi. So xi, that is the middle value, class mark, lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So 11 plus 13 upon 2, that is 24 upon 2, that is 12. And here it will be 14, because middle value. Then 15 plus 16, 18, 20, 22, then 24. So these are the class mark. Then fi into xi, then we will find the product of this one, 7 into 12, 6 into 14 we will write up, 9 into 16, 13 into 18, then we will write here 20f. Then product of this one, then product of this. Then we will find the sum of fi xi, sigma fi xi. So when we find the sum of these all numbers, so we can find these sum of these all numbers plus sum of these two numbers. So you may get a number plus 20F. 20F. So that is sigma Fi Xi. So here 7 into 12 we will get one number, 6 into 14, 9 into 16, 13 into 20, 18, then here it is 20F, 20 into F that is 20F, then 5 into 22 another number, 4 into 24 again. So we can find the sum of these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So when we find the sum of that numbers, we will get a number here plus 20F, that is sigma Fi Xi. And here mean is equal to 18, then we will write the formula, mean is equal to sigma Fi Xi divided by sigma Fi equal to 18. And sigma Fi, that is sum of the frequency, and here I think it's given. The following distribution, it's not given, following distribution, yes. Then sum of the frequency, sigma Fi. So when we find sigma Fi, we can find sum of these all numbers. So here one variable is there, that is F. So when we find the sum of these numbers, suppose we got one number plus F, you will get here. One number plus F. And here, when we replace this value, so sigma Fi Xi, sigma Fi, a number plus 20F divided by another number plus F equal to 18. Now we can cross multiply. From here we will get the value of F. So that will be the missing frequency. So we can easily find, you will not face any problem. So when we find their sum, we will get one number here, and we will get another number here. So that is sum of these all numbers plus F, another number. And when we cross multiply this one, 18 into this number plus 18 into F equal to a number plus 20F, then the terms containing F you will take in one side, then you will find the value of F. So we can easily find the missing frequency. So that is exercise 14.1, mean. So these all questions you can do by yourself. So missing frequency questions, when we do missing frequency questions, direct method, that may be easy.